Hey crypto friends, how's it going? I'm Michael Zelbe. In this video, I want to purchase and set up two Sensedge Mini air quality sensors from the manufacturer Kaiterra. I want to purchase them on Planetwatch and use them for the Planetwatch project. These Sensedge Mini sensors, they are premium indoor sensors, and I want to use one in my house, especially near the area where our bedroom is, and I'm mostly interested in CO2 levels. And the other one I would like to use in my hobby photo studio, which is in an old barn nearby. This studio is not heated during the winter time, so I'm especially interested in humidity. I'm logged into Planetwatch on planetwatch.io, and I'm logged in with the email address that I used a couple of weeks ago to purchase licenses. I went to licenses and I got myself two type-free licenses. And then I waited, and today I received an email which says, "Buy your Kaiterra before October 20th. Congratulations, Planet Watchers." It says, "As you hold two type-free licenses, you can buy a total of two Kaiterra Sensedge Mini devices under the following link." I did not receive anything else regarding the license. I did not receive a license key or something, and that might feel strange to many users, but here on Planetwatch, the licenses are really just bound to the email. And when I receive my Sensedge Mini sensors and when I activate them, then my licenses will be really used. But for now, I can click on buy now and see what happens. It leads me to a purchase page. It says, "Congratulations, as you hold two licenses, you can buy a total of two devices. You've already bought zero." Fantastic. So let's add two devices to my shopping cart. That's roughly 1,000 euro. I can proceed to checkout. The checkout page already got my details because I'm logged in, and from previous purchases, this is all taken over. I have to confirm, for example, the privacy policy, and can continue to pay. Since I am in Europe, I definitely have to pay with Planets, which, well, is good because I want to earn Planets and pay with Planets, and when we all use them a lot, then they gain in value. I say I want to use my Algorand wallet because that's a wallet that I have on my Android phone. Let me bring my Android device screen over here into the video. I will open my Algorand wallet, and there I've got my main account, Algo64, and that one has got enough Planets, so I will pay using this account. I click on the Planets, I click send, and then I copy the amount from the payment page over here and paste it into this field. Then I click on address and I copy the address from the payment page and paste it into the address field. That should be it. I don't need to add a note. I can click on preview and then send Planets. That might take a moment. The wallet got the confirmation that the Planets are sent, and the payment page also confirms that the payment was successful. It's now 2 weeks later. I received my two Kaiterra sensors in the mail. That made me happy. I just activated the first one of them because I wanted to check whether or not this is actually working for me. Planetwatch has released their new app, and there is an announcement regarding that on their blog under planetwatch.io. But the app is still a bit buggy. And they also released instructions for setting up the Kaiterra sensor, but I found these instructions misleading in some of the steps. But I went through all of that with my first sensor. It worked. So now I would like to film how I activate the second sensor. For that, I downloaded the Kaiterra Enterprise Configuration Tool. I visited support.kaiterra.com, scrolled down, And there is a link, download the Kaiterra Enterprise Configuration Tool. I went there, scrolled down again, and here I had options for macOS, Windows, Linux, and mobile platforms. And I selected the Windows version and installed it. I can open it. It doesn't show all that much, but it's the tool I need for the initial configuration. So I just inserted the cartridges into my sensor. It doesn't matter which cartridge is in which slot. And I switched it on. It's now blinking. And that means that it opened a Wi-Fi network, which I can use for the initial configuration of the sensor. On my laptop, I am opening the Wi-Fi settings. And beside my home Wi-Fi network, I find a Kaiterra network. So let's join this Kaiterra network. And once I'm connected, I change to the configuration tool. I click on configure and it finds this Kaiterra sensor. One important information that I will need later on is this UDID. It is the device ID of this specific sensor. So I copy this ID and I keep it in my notepad for the moment, just so that I have it later on in the process. Here's a bit of information about the sensor. It has got the two cartridges, which are both brand new. That's fantastic. So I can click on the menu item configure to set up the Wi-Fi connection. So I go to preferred connection and say this is Wi-Fi. And then I have to enter the name of my Wi-Fi network, exactly how it is usually displayed when I connect with other devices to this network. So let's do that. Now I have to enter the password to the Wi-Fi network. I'm not going to film the password, of course, but I will enter it here so that the Kaiterra sensor can always connect to Wi-Fi in the future. I entered the password. Other than that, I don't have to change anything or select anything else. I double check that this device will be connected to the internet, is checked, and the other two boxes are not checked. And then I can click on configure device so that this configuration is uploaded. It says your device has been configured, and that's all that I need in this tool. It also automatically disables this Wi-Fi network of the Kaiterra sensor. So now my laptop should be in my home Wi-Fi network again. Let's double check that. Yes, it connected to my standard network. So that's all for the configuration tool. Next up is the Kaiterra dashboard. This is at dashboard.kaiterra.cn. And the first thing that you might have to do is to follow the link sign up here and then sign up with your email for a free dashboard account. I already did that for the first sensor, so I will just log in here. I'm not going to film the login, but I will just log into my new account. Inside my account, I find the Sensedge Mini that I already activated, but now I want to add a new device, so I click on Add Device. And this is where I need this UDID again. So I will copy it from my notepad and paste it into the field device UDID, add device. And there we are. It already onboarded the device into the Kaiterra dashboard. I will keep the dashboard open in the browser for the moment because I need it in a later step in order to copy the API key of the Kaiterra dashboard. But for now, I am done with the browser. I move it to the side and I will continue on my Android device. Over there, I already have the new Planetwatch app. If you don't have the app, then visit the Google Play Store or the App Store on an iOS device and search for Planetwatch. And there are two hits. One is Planetwatch, and that's the app that you need. And the other one is Planetwatch Wearable. This is only the app for the AtmoTube Pro sensor. We don't need that one at the moment. We just need the Planetwatch app. I open the app. And the very first thing I like to do is creating a new wallet. I like to have separate wallets for each of my sensors. So let's go to the wallets tab over here and say plus. I don't need to enable this biometric authorization, even though it's very good, but let's not do that. I say I create a new account because I want to create a wallet account, and I will call it Sensedge House because it is a sensor that I have in my house. Next. Now it shows me my 25-word passphrase, and like always, it's super, super important that I store this passphrase at a really safe place. I'm not going to film how I copy and store this passphrase, but I'm going to do that right now. I secured the passphrase and my wallet account is created. Can scroll down and there I see Sensedge House. The wallet is empty, but I will need a little bit of algos for transaction fee. The blog post of Planetwatch says that they are going to send me the necessary algos. And I can also see on previous wallets that they had done that, but they did it very late and not when I needed it. So in order to speed things up, I will send myself one algo so that I can continue over here. I click the three dots. I go to copy wallet address because I want to copy the public address of my new wallet. And then I change to my Algorand wallet. There I've got my main account and it got some algos. So I click on algos. I click on send. I type in one algo, which is much more than I need for transaction fees. I click on address, and here I paste in the public address of my new wallet account. Then I scroll down, click on preview, and click on send algos. This is on its way. That's just confirmed that it is sent. So let's go to the Planetwatch app and check if it arrived. I scroll down again to Sensedge House and there is one algo. Now I can pay transaction fees with this account. I will directly add the Planet asset while I'm here. So I click on plus, add the Planet asset, then on OK, add Planet asset. I really love it that Planetwatch made it so easy in here to set up the wallet. This is easier than setting it up manually before. Okay, the wallet is there. With that in place, I can now go ahead and add the sensor. So I go to sensors and there I click the plus icon at the top. And then I select type 3 because the Sensedge Mini sensor is a type 3 sensor. And in the field sensor ID, I copy in the UDID, which is still in my notepad. So let's copy that one more time and paste it in over here. This is the sensor ID. And in the field token, I have to add the API key from the Kaiterra dashboard. So let's go to the dashboard and then click my profile icon, then on account settings and onto API keys. Over there, I've got my one and only API key. I copy this one and I paste it into the token field. I can click on proceed. From here on, I will not need the web browser anymore. So let's put that away. Now I have to choose a wallet account, and I choose the one that I just created, Sensedge House. I have to fill in the address where the sensor will be operated. So I'm going to fill that in, but I'm not going to film that. I click on proceed. And now it's activating the sensor. It says license added successfully. That is fantastic. So later on, I will check in the Planetwatch Explorer if the sensor is really added successfully and if it's working. And then in 2 days from now, I'm going to check if I receive the rewards for that sensor in my new Algorand wallet. Now it has been 5 days since I activated my sensor. Planetwatch had a little bit of issues with their system, so they disabled payouts for a couple of days, but now it's all back on track. I'm now in the Explorer at explorer.planetwatch.io. I logged into the Explorer. When I click on my profile icon, then I can go to my sensors, and this gives me an overview of all the sensors that I've activated together with detailed information. And one of them is the Kaiterra that I just activated in the video, but that's now 5 days ago. And here is all the information about that sensor. I can go to my Algorand wallet address over here, and there I would see that the sensor is streaming roughly every 15 minutes. And there is one transaction 1 hour ago where I received a reward of 30.552 planets. This is the regular reward, the maximum reward, according to the white paper. And then half an hour ago, I received the additional 15.276 planets, which is the additional bonus that Planetwatch is paying us until the end of the year. And until the end of the year, they also want to initiate a community vote regarding increasing the default payout to 45 planets. And they want to update the white paper then. But right now there is 2 different reward transactions per day. And this might be strange to some users, but that's just how it is. The total would be 45.8 something planets. So let's have a look what that actually means. I go to coinmarketcap.com/currencies/planetwatch. There I find the current price of the planet. There's also a converter. So let's say I have 45.8 planets. What is this worth? At the current rate, it's $16.72, which is a very nice reward for a single day, in my opinion. But hey, we are into crypto, so don't take any of this as financial advice. Yes, anything can happen in crypto. The price of the planet can collapse to zero, then the rewards and all my coins are worth nothing. Something could go wrong with the Planetwatch project. I mean, of course, always things can go wrong. So there's a lot of risk. But for right now, if things remain like they are, I'm pretty darn happy with the reward. I hope you will also join Planetwatch with a type-free sensor, and I hope you get a lot of rewards too. I also hope I see you in the next video.